May ipapakita po kaming mga Epoch Times na mga news articles na kinokumpirma siyang kasamang inmate ni Xie Zhijiang. Ayan po. And ngayon, ipapakita po namin sa lahat ang video ng nagawang Zoom interview kay Wang Fugui.
Can you tell us your full name?
My name is Wang Fugui.
Do you consent that this video will be shown in the Senate hearing? For better feedback, you can answer in Chinese.
Yes, we will fully support the hearings in the Philippines.
Mr. Wang, what is your association with Xie Zhijiang and how long have you known him?
我是他的狱友。 我们是相互信任的朋友，因为我们在监狱里面生活1.5年的时间，在我出狱后，受他的委托处理一些他简密档案的一些事务。How
did you come to access his files?
应该准确的说，是他给了我部分简密档案的权限，我也只是这些文件中的一个保管者。 但每一个文件需要打开的话，都是要由佘志江先生本人的解密口令才能打开。
In the Al Jazeera documentary that just came out, you revealed that the file of Guo Huaping was found in the files of Mr. Xie Zhijiang. How did you come to the conclusion that Alice Guo or Guo Huaping is a spy based on the fact that her file is with Xie, with Mr. Xie?
其实佘志良先生保管的解密档案的内容非常多，而且我也只是在他授权下解密了一部分内容而已。郭华平并不是什么特殊的，只是正好有一份他的国安背景的资料在里面。他的情况和佘志良先生有很多相似的点。 我也只能说到这里了，因为我不是佘志江先生本人。按照我和佘志江先生的约定，我只能透露这么多了，抱歉。When
and how, if you know only that Guo Huaping was recruited to become a spy, would you know the circumstances of her recruitment and why she was specifically recruited?
这个情况，佘志江先生在监狱中就跟我说了一些。首先，所有的 国安招募的外勤特务都会有非常详细的背景资料调查，也有专门的黑客小组和同乡会、商会负责海外的资料收集，包括背景资料里面会掌握一些人的秘密和弱点，这也是国安在海外控制外勤的主要方法。比如郭华平的假菲律宾身份，就是这样的秘密和弱点，他只能听从国安的话。佘志良先生的经历 也是有相似的特点。As
a spy, what was Guo Huaping's assignment? Do you know what information she passed to the Chinese government and what kind of a spy was she?
这些问题的话，需要直接询问佘志良先生本人，因为他是最主要的知情人。中共国安在招募海外特遣人员的时候，虽然包含专门收集情报的 间谍人员，但是也有很多为了中国政府谋取政治和经济利益的，比如有些国家的官员和商人。Who
else in her family and associates are involved in the spying operations? And if you know the answer, in what ways are they involved?
这个内容的话，我目前没有权限回答你们了，因为太复杂，涉及的面非常广泛。我只能告诉你们，中国政府的胃口非常大，手也伸得非常远。Can
you try to explain to us how the casino, online gambling, maybe scamming businesses are related to the spying or espionage operations?
这些当然有关联的。 这和中国政府旺盛的情报需求有很大的关系。还有一个就是这些和一带一路是绝对有关联的。而一带一路也是面向全世界庞大的统战和情报战略计划的一部分，包括对外的殖民策略。
Why do you think that Xie is telling the truth?
我是当然相信的。如果你们看了这些文件，你们也会相信。
To your knowledge, are there other Chinese spies in the Philippines?
每个国家的都有，而且并不完全是华人。我只能回答这些了。
In the Al Jazeera interview, Xie talked about a handler who was the go-between between Guo Huaping and Xie. Who is this handler? Is he also working for Yatai? Or is he connected to the government? Is he the handler of Guo Huaping? So all things that you can say about him.
这个人叫马东丽，他是中共的党员。他是佘志良先生的国安联络人，是红二代的身份，当然他也有一个美国的身份，还有他是泰国华人协会的副会长。他在佘志良先生被非法诱捕之前是亚太排名第三的高层，他很有可能是郭华平的上线。佘志良先生和郭华平之间的联系就是通过马东丽。我也只能回答这些问题了，谢谢。
To your knowledge, was Guo Huaping planted here as a spy, like when she was a child, or did she first become very successful, then became a mayor, before she was tapped to work for the Chinese government?
郭华平的竞选本身就是中共国安安排的。
After the Al Jazeera interview, Mr. Wang, you had to move to an undisclosed location. Can you tell us why that was necessary?
这个是有必要的，因为不能小看中国国安的海外执行能力。我也希望听证会的议员们注意安全。
Have you tried to contact Mr. Xie after the Al Jazeera documentary? Were you able to get in touch with him?
佘志良先生目前因为接入郭华平女士涉及的间谍事件，据悉已遭到了中国政府的严密打压。由于此事件非常的敏感，泰国监狱方面对佘志良先生实行了严格的监控，已经限制了他与外界的联系。
To the best of your knowledge, would she be willing to speak to Philippine authorities, Philippine government?If access to him was granted,
据我所了解，佘志良本人对菲律宾的感情是非常深厚的。因为的话，他曾经说过，菲律宾给了他改变穷苦身份的机会，所以他很感恩于菲律宾。他本人也说过，他一生从未做过伤害菲律宾人民的行为，而且他在菲律宾所有的商业都是符合菲律宾法律的。
So finally, before we move back into executive session,
can you tell us
I wish to express that we really need to talk to Xie Zijiang and the DFA, hopefully, should make it happen. Of course, mga kaibigan, we know that Wang and Xie perhaps have their own agenda and interests, and we are